U wilde dit graag laten zien. Dit is uw grootste trofee, Wout Mellenthin. Ja. Want u heeft alle platen en allemaal dubbel en bootlegs en noem maar op. Maar dit is, legt
dit
u het eens uit?
Dit is de playlist. Dit is Melanie Concert in de Doelen in Rotterdam.
Ja.
Toen was ik zwanger van Kylie.
Ja.
En dit was haar playlist.
Dit was het lijstje wat ze op het toneel had om te kijken in welke volgorde ze de nummer zou spelen. En die heeft u gekregen of gepikt? Of,
gepikt.
Ja, ja, ja. Nou ja, prachtig.
We zijn er het podium voor opgekropen.
Ja, echt waar? Ja, ja. Nou, Melanie staat er twee keer in. Een beetje laag, geloof ik. Dus dat moet volgend jaar een duwtje krijgen, ja, hè, wat jullie betreft. We gaan nu eens kijken naar Melanie toen, te gast bij Willem Duis. En Melanie nu.
En... Tell us a little more about yourself. How old are you?
I'm 23.
23?
Uh-huh. And, well, I'd like to tell you about the song.
Yes, tell me about the song.
Well, I wrote it after a big peace festival in the United States. And that was the Woodstock Festival. I don't know if you heard that.
Yes, just a second. Ze heeft het lied dat ze straks ten gehoor gaat brengen geschreven na een groot vredesfestival in Woodstock in Amerika.
People weren't there to hear music. Nobody cared if Bob Dylan showed up or didn't show up. And nobody cared if the Rolling Stones came or they didn't. I mean, yes, it was great if some super group came because it would mean, you know, that they thought so too. You know, that they were in agreement with this awareness or awakening. It was like an awakening. It was a time where there was almost a near a renaissance on earth. That's how I felt. After it was over, I had this fantastic feeling and the song just came like that. But we just couldn't record it all by myself. We knew it was something special. So the first thing that came to my mind was that wouldn't it be nice if a religious group or some group could sing with me? But I didn't dream that the Edwin Hawkins Singers would do it because they were very big, you know. Yeah.
And he said, oh, we can't do anything unless it has Jesus's name or, you know, says the Lord in some way, praises the Lord. And I went, well, you know, I mean, I'm feeling like this has to be, you know, this is divine, you know. I said, well, he's in there, you know, he's in there. And so he said, well, you know, let me listen to it. And so I flew to California and they were rehearsing in a high school gym. And I went to the gym and I was shy really. And I took my guitar and I thought, I can't believe I'm doing this. Oh, you know, 50 black gospel singers, real powerful, big singers. And I'm gonna sing this song to them. Well, by the time I was in the middle of the song, singing the chorus for the second time, people were just singing with me.
Well, I think, why not do it?
Sure.
Yeah. Dames en heren, Melanie en de Edwin Hawkins Singers samen in Lay Down.
During my set that this candlelighting thing started happening. So I saw it in front of me, it was dark, you know, and all I could see was this field lighting up. It was like an arc of candles. It was just because the field went like that and the people in the back, I could see this like 1,000 fireflies, you know. It's just, it was incredible. And at that time too, I felt this surge of positive energy and power flowing to me, you know. It was, and it made me feel safe. You know, I was okay. I was with my people, you know, and it was, I think, you know, starting your career out singing in front of 500,000 people is a really good thing to do.
Some came to pray, some came to keep the dark away. So pray,
pray,
pray
up high.
For thinking only good day black again tonight. Oh, pray,
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 Melanie, een werkelijk wonderschoon nummer. Ik geloof dat ik alle nummers vanavond wonderschoon vind. Ontzettend bedankt dat jullie reclame hebben gemaakt voor deze zangeres. Peace. Oké.